Hey guys, welcome back to my project. I'm Eric here. Today, following the previous project, we will complete the Flutter app for the hardware connectivity. Because there are great packages, you can easily complete the app using them. I will proceed quickly with the basic parts like making UI. I'm thinking about making a basic UI tutorial when I have time later. Thanks for your understanding. Also, you can download the source code from my GitHub. I hope it's helpful. This screen you are looking at, like a scene from Mission Impossible I just imagined, is creating an app. Also, if I have a good chance, I'd like to talk about animation for Flutter app. I hope you just watch it for fun. Okay then, let's start today's project. The absolutely necessary library for this project is this USB serial package. It makes the serial connection through USB very easy. There is a list of supported devices below. If the USB to serial to chip you are currently using is not listed above, it's impossible to use this library. So please check it first. In my case, my ESP32 TTGO has a CP2104 USB to UART bridge, so it works. Before we create a new Flutter project, let's check the current version. I'm using version 1.22.5 on the stable channel. Please check yours. I use Android Studio when I develop the Flutter app. There is no difference in development with VS Code, so please make a Flutter project from the development ID you have. When you create a new Flutter app in Android Studio, the dummy blows arrays. We don't need this part, so I will start after removing it all. There is a code for unit test to allow you to have a test code as well as a widget. Since I don't use this function, I will remove all of them. Okay, now we have a very clean code. Actually, it has nothing. I will add the USB serial package to my project. Go to your pubspec YAML file and add the USB serial under the dependencies. After that, run the pubget. There is a button in the upper right corner of the screen. Everything we need is explained in the description, so we can add it accordingly. Let's add the compile options in the Android app build gradle. Under the Android object, please paste it on. It says without this, you will get a bunch of Java errors. The reason is that this package has a serial communication library for Android and is required to build it. Create a folder called XML in Android app main res. I will create an XML file called device filter, and I will copy and put the items about the device in there. This also makes notify your app when one of the specified devices is plugged in. The next one is adding the intent filter. Add the intent filter to the Android manifest to allow the app to open automatically. You can add it directly over the closed activity tag. Finally, all the settings related to the basic Android build have been completed. Since our environment has been configured, let's run the example the package provides. If you go to the example tab, you can see there is a source code which is ready. I will copy all of this and paste it into the current main .dot file of my project. As you can see, the source code is not that long and no errors found. First, let's build it into the Android device and see how it works. I connected my Android phone and selecting the target device. For your information, hardware-related projects cannot be tested in the emulator. A physical device is required. Okay, then let me press the play button to run it. This is the example app from the ESP serial package. Here is the ESP32 TTGO hardware I made in the previous video. Once the USB is connected, both will start. ESP32 TTGO starts playing digital range animation, and the app detects the connected port. Touch the connect button to connect this port. It's connected and you can see the connected text in the status. Let's enter the keyword key question mark that allows you to receive random keys. It has received a random key from ESP32 TTGO and you can see that the screen has changed from green to red. In the previous video, we are doing the same thing that we did on Arduino serial monitor through the app. Now let's enter any key to go back to the normal mode. Yes, it changed from red to green properly. Through this, we have confirmed that the serial communication is possible with the USB serial normally. Let's talk about the source code simply. Go to init state and see what functions are called. There is a listener in the event stream in the USB serial to invoke get ports whenever the event occurs. Then what does the get ports do? Gets a list of the devices on the USB port. It's adding as many list types as found for connecting. Also, it has a button to call the connect function. If we look at the connect function, if it's connected and the port is open, it's canceling first and reconnecting. Cancels connections, subscriptions, and returns without connecting if the device that is passed through the parameter is null. For connecting, set the serial baud rate, stop bit, and parity options for your serial come here. At the transaction string terminates, you can see that the string cut off by 13 and 10. 13 means carriage returns, which is ASCII CR. 10 means line feed, which is ASCII LF. You can receive incoming string through the listener of the transaction string. You can see that the incoming string is added to the serial data after inserting it to the text widget. Let's go to the build and see how to draw the screen. The size of the port array indicates whether there is a device currently available or not. There is a triple dot in front of the ports array. It can be used to extend the elements of the collection. Anyway, the ports array is a widget array that has items from a device can be connected, so it appears on the screen as it is. There is a text field that can be entered to send a string, and when the send button is pressed, it's writing to the directory connected port. Lastly, the serial data array, which is a collection of the data from the device, is being output to the screen. This is all for this example source code. Based on this, I will complete the actual app. Here is one package we need, it's getx. I know you guys are familiar with this package for your development. The reason for using getx is to make state management effective. You can also use other packages like a provider. I'm gonna only use it in a simple way to notify on any page when the device is disconnected. I'm gonna create one controller with getx and put a code inside that allows me to communicate with the hardware through the USB serial. Create a class called serial controller and inherit the getx controller. Then we can override a few callback functions. OnInit function is called immediately after the widget is allocated memory. On the other hand, onClose is just called before the controller is deleted from the memory. It's working like an init state and dispose in the stateful widget. Okay, then I'm gonna copy the USB serial from the main to this controller. Let me show you how to make it. Import everything in this. This controller no longer needs the set state to update the screen, so I will remove it. Also, I will remove all the parts that draw the screen here because the drawing part will be in the main, not in the controller. Text controller usually initialized at onInit. the USB event stream listener will also start at on init. And on closed, disposing not only the text controller but connected device. Remove this part that is no longer needed from the main. I will add the necessary one from the controller, a create string to store the random key after the hardware connection, and a log string to show the log message on the screen. We will also create a reactive stream object that indicates that the hardware key is connected or not. GetX makes it simple to create an object by pasting OBS after a value. I will save it in a log message to see the product ID and vendor ID of the device from the USB port. If the PID and VID is the device I want, mark it as the target device. In my case, I already know both PID and VID, so I will use this to connect it without pressing the button. Also, you can find yours from here. Connecting only if the value of the hardware key connected is false. This getPort function is called continuously from the USB event stream, so it was only allowed to be connected when the connection was not established. Displaying a message that is connected using the snack bar. Finally, if the target device is not detected, always make a hardware key connected false. This is to notify pages that are watching this value, so we can easily know the current status. Create a function to send a string to the connected device. Sending the string in the unsigned 8-bit integer. When the target device is found and connected, send the keyword key question mark to the connected device. Then ESP32 TTGO will return the random key. Now what we need to do is store the random keys that we received from the device. Go to the stream listener of the transaction. I will save the string from the device to the key from device and enter it into the text controller automatically. In fact, I tried to have the user type the key string of the ESP32 device directory, but it's too annoying, so I added this part. If desired, remove this part so that user can enter the key themselves. Making a simple validation function to verify that the key obtained from the device and the key entered by the user are the same. If the same, send any key to ESP32 return to either mode. The reason why the return type is the future bool is that I will treat it asynchronously. This completes the controller, which is the most important. Let's go back to the main page and complete the screen. Because it used GetX, it will configure the screen accordingly. There is nothing special about UI, so I will proceed quickly. You can download the Discord via the link below. Please refer to it. Also, if you have a question, please leave your comment on this video. Since our status management is done by the controller, draw the screen with the status widget. Serial controller is placed in GetX for anywhere use. Because it configured the screen using GetX builder, you can access the serial controller directly. The most important thing here is whether the serial controller's hardware key connected is true or false. If it's true, you can see the text controller on the serial controller and the button to go to the next page. Otherwise, you can display this message, please insert your key to proceed. Oops, there is an underbar in front of the text controller. This means a private variable, so remove the underbar for external access. Press this button to execute the validation function we made earlier. If it returns true, it let us go to the next page. This completes the first page. In fact, because the controller controls everything, we can only focus on how to construct the view. The second page is almost empty. I just need to add one more thing, OBX. This one is personal favorite. It has the simplest syntax and implementation. All we have to do is wrap the widget in OBX and we are done. Let me show you how to use this. If the value of the hardware key connected changes and is false, the code that goes backward is executed. Pretty simple, isn't it? Finally, the last modification is to remove the serial controller that was put into getX. This part is not required because the screen was configured using getX builder. Just replace serial controller with the underbar. That's all. Let's build and see how it works. No apps are running in the background. If I connect my device here, the app will open. Currently, my ESP32 TTGO operates in the random scan mode, so it's making a random key with 24 characters. Press the confirm button to go to the next page. As I said before, you can also enter the key of your hardware yourself. When you remove the device from your phone, it returns to the first page. It works as expected. I have been working on a project that connects hardware and apps. In the next project, I will try a more interesting one. I hope you guys like it. Okay then, thank you always. See you in the next project.